This DNews episode is brought to you by domain.com.
I don't know about you, but thunderstorms scare the hell out of me. Lightning may never strike in the same place twice, but based on the following video, I think we're going to run out of places to hide real, real soon. Hey folks, I'm Matt Lieberman, filling in for DNews. According to climate scientists from the University of California, Berkeley, global warming will cause the amount of air-to-ground lightning strikes to increase by 50% by the end of this century. Now, that may feel far away right now, but the road to Lightning-palooza, as it will now be called, is not going to be fun for anyone. So, how are global warming and lightning connected? Well, lightning strikes are caused by charge separation in clouds, which are composed of water and ice molecules. Atmospheric water molecules are essentially lightning fuel. Now, increased global temperatures will cause more water to evaporate into the atmosphere. Imagine a bomb dropped into a barrel of gunpowder in one of those old school rooms that's just packed to the gills with TNT in a house that's on fire. You get the picture. The opportunity for explosive deep convection skyrockets under these conditions, sharply raising the risk of human injury and wildfires. Jeez! Now, hold on, excuse me, science? How'd we get to this conclusion? Well, I'll tell you, me! You see, convection, the thermal transfer of energy through fluid and gas, has long been measured by precipitation, namely the amount of rain, snow, and hail that hits the ground during a given period. However, that doesn't account for the ascent speeds of moisture into the atmosphere. This is a factor known as CAPE, or convective available potential energy, which is measured via instruments released twice daily into the atmosphere via weather balloons. Essentially, CAPE measures how fast and far a moist pocket of air could travel into the upper atmosphere, releasing explosive charges. Armed with this information, scientists can now actually predict 77% of lightning strikes. As it turns out, CAPE in the US will rise by 11% for every degree Celsius that our global temperature rises. Combined with small increases in precipitation levels and based on the projected 4-degree increase worldwide by 2100, lightning strikes will rise by 50%. Just another reason to try to curb global warming before it zaps us back. So, how do you feel about lightning? Are you concerned about the potential increase? Let us know down in the comments below. I'm Matt Lieberman, filling in for DNews. You can find more of my videos over at SourceFed and on my personal channel, youtube.com/MatthewDLieberman. Please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.